Okay, so hello everyone. Hello from Ukraine. My name is Anastasia Zazuliak. You're watching Channel 24. And today we talk with Inber Bezek, who is Israeli activist and politician. She was a member of Knesset of Yesh Aid from 2021 till 2022. So nice to meet you.
Hi, good afternoon.
Thank you so much for your time. It's very important for us, for Ukraine, to talk with you. So, and you know, I want to start from that mention that Russia covers its imperial goals with statements about the alleged existence of Nazism and fascism in Ukraine. And with this statement, the world community has already stopped reacting. And all this is happening despite the fact that our president, Volodymyr Zelensky, is actually a Jew. And more than that, Lavrov has already stated that he found even a Jew blood in Hitler. So how does the society and the establishment of your country react to this information policy of Russian Federation at all?
So it depends. I think that like in any democracy, every person react differently, but obviously as general, as our government, we were looking at the statement and everything that happens in your region in a big concern, because we as Jews that were also been in this situation, that we were attacked because of our nationality, it's something that Israelis and Jews all around the world don't see in a good way when people are attacked by their nationality. And every place in the world, when we see governments trying to occupy, they're trying to take force other areas, is something that we don't see as in a positive way. We understand that the situation in Russia and Ukraine is complex. Like you know, people from all the world look at Israel, but as if you don't live in the place, you cannot understand the complexity. So I feel it's not it won't be smart if we give our opinion on a situation that we're not part of it, but obviously we are against every aggression, any type of aggression from Russian against Ukraine. It doesn't matter if what the reason is.
Well, and then how significant the influence of Russia or its propaganda of public opinion in Israel? How much influence does so-called like Russian street you have in countries like an official name of people from the post-Soviet countries, because many of them still watch Russian TV and read Russian press?
Yeah, in Israel, we have a high percentage of immigrants that arrived from Russia, Jews that arrived from Russia, and definitely they have a lot of power. Power on the government and power on the press and people's opinions. As general, again, it's not everybody thinks the same, but as general, the Russian population in Israel are supporting the Ukrainian side in your conflict. And we also, because we understand, and again, Jews and Russian Jews were in a similar situation in different times of history, Israel is is doing a lot of efforts to help Jews from Ukraine to come to Israel and give them a shelter, give them a safe place. And that's again, part of the Russian population that are promoting that and they're assisting that. There's a lot of Russian people that are helping people from Ukraine to immigrate, and then when they come to Israel, they help them to get their new life. They have the language, they have the support, they have the relationship.
Well, and you know, for a long time, Israel has been actively opposing the fighting of Iran in the Middle East. And what is, in your opinion, prevents Tel Aviv from doing this in Ukraine right now? After all, Iran's drones fall on our heads every time when we hear the raid, you know, and Israel helps in fighting against the common enemy could be very important for all of us.
Obviously, as I already noted, Israel is supporting the Ukrainian side in this conflict. But on the other hand, Israel is very much affected from Russia with our border with Syria, from Russia and also by Iran with the border with Syria, which is controlled by Hezbollah, which is controlled by forces from Iran and from Russia. So Israel is trying to be... To at least on the diplomatic side, trying to be very careful on what we say and how we act. But again, we do whatever we can to support and to assist the Ukrainian citizen. But it's too much of a risk from our side to on the diplomatic side to be very very active against Russia, because it will also affect us.
Well, Israel has a really high-tech and modern weapon, of course, and so if there is a possibility that Israel will decide to assist Ukraine in resisting Russian aggression, and what should Ukraine do to happen that?
Okay, so the Israeli policy is to assist on the side of defense and not on the offense side, again from the same reasons I just noted, that we have to be very careful with how we act against or with the Russian government. So Israel decided that we do whatever we can to give the defensive technology, but not to promote offensive technologies. We have Israel as a country that has been for many, many years in a conflict situation with our borders. We have very strong and advanced defense technologies. I think one of the most advanced in the world. And I know that we are assisting, that we are working with the Ukraine government and with Ukraine army, but again on a very sensitive areas that we can do that without creating a crisis situation or a conflict situation with the Russian government.
Well, recently Israel's ambassador to Ukraine stated that Russia has still plays very important role in the Middle East. So do you agree with this statement, and how it affects Israel's reluctance to spoil relations with Russia, and in particular in the context of supplying weapons or even humanitarian aids in the both way, maybe it can be publicly or privately?
Yeah, so again, it's the same, I'm repeating the same thing I just noted, that we are doing whatever we can to help and support the citizens of Ukraine, but we won't be able to take more active act in your conflict, because it affects us. It affects us on our borders. So I totally support and agree with the ambassador's claims that everything that Israel will do in this area, in your area, will affect us with our diplomatic relationship with Russia. It affects our situation in the border, and so I agree that we need to be very precise in what we can assist in your conflict, which is again more defense and assisting the citizens, and less take active part in the war activities.
Well,
in supplying weapons, in supplying technologies for attacking, etc.
Well, throughout history, Israel has been a hostile environment, and the goal of which was destruction of the state of Israel. And now Russia has the same goals regarding Ukraine. So what could be a guarantee of non-repetition, the Russia again aggression again? What do you think?
It's a wrong way to look at it. Israel is not an aggression country. We never had an aggression policy. Since the day Israel was announced, we are constantly being attacked from all around, from the countries around us, from people who live inside Israel. We still don't have a solution for the Palestinians' problem, and Israelis are under terror and under attack on a daily basis. So it's not the same situation like in Russia. I know that Russian citizens are not going on buses and afraid to be exploded every day by the Ukrainian citizens. So it's totally a wrong way to compare it. The situation in Israel is totally different than the situation in Russia, and Israel is not similar to Russia. Israel, all the years of the existence, are trying to separate from Palestine and separate from the areas that were occupied in 67. The reason it hasn't happened yet because there is no safe solution.
Well, and then the last question is, in your opinion, is it important for majority of Israel population how exactly the war between Ukraine and between Russia and Ukraine will end, with the Ukrainian victory or just the end of hostilities?
Well, definitely the best way is the end of hostility. I don't see in the current situation, none of you are going to win. You already everybody lost. The Russian has lost, the Ukraine has lost. There are no winning in war. I believe eventually the only way to solve hostility in any place in the world is diplomatic, in diplomatic ways and not in hostility and in army solutions. Definitely, I believe that most, again, I'm talking as a citizen and as a person. I can't talk on behalf of all the Israeli citizens, but I can assume that the majority of Israelis, because we have been in a situation of hostility and war throughout our all since the beginning of the country until today, we are constantly under attacks and hostility situation. I believe that the majority of Israelis are wishing for the end of a quick end of this war and quick end of the aggression from the Russian side. And we're wishing the Russian and Ukraine to find a way to live side by side peacefully. It's something that I believe people in the world, most of the people in the world, are wishing that. The problem is not people. The problem is usually the leaders that has their own ways to solve problems. And I wish both sides will be able to sit and talk and solve it as quick as possible.
Well, really, we hope that this war will end soon. And I'm really thankful for you for this time. And thank you that you found time to talk with us for some time. I hope that our talk will be very important and very interesting for a lot of people who will read us or watch us. So thank you so much.